Kelsey Grammer, welcome to the project. This is a bit of a pinch me moment for me. Congratulations on this new iteration of Frasier.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Georgie. I appreciate it.
What does it feel like to be back? Is it surreal?
Well, yeah, there's a surreal quality to it. Being back and favorably received as Frasier is a real feather in the cap. There have been some guys that said, oh, why, blah, 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 blah. But, you know, who cares? You know, they're just noise.
Why do you think Frasier has endured?
Justice, it's a great question. You might even be better qualified to answer it, but I think it's because he's so committed, so in love, with life, with the things that come his way. He never quits. And he's filled with every shortcoming that every human being can have. And I think people find that endearing. And no matter what his background is, no matter how much success he's had, he's still a little bit tortured, but still always in it with his whole heart. And that is what has always made him unique and wonderful.
One notable absence from the reboot is Frasier's beloved dad, played by John Mahoney, who died in 2018.
What was it like for you coming back and working on this series with, you know, without one of the core family members?
It was always determined that if someone wanted to do this show again, we had to honor John and honor his passing and honor his passing as, you know, the passing of Martin. So it was like losing a father. And that was emotional. It just was. And you don't shy away from it. You just go for it and embrace it. And I had other things in mind as to how to interject him that technically didn't work so well. So I wanted Frasier to be able to see him for a moment and realize, oh, my dad wants this. You know, so we thought that we had to let that go, and just let Frasier have his moment before he offers his son the flag. And it seemed to work beautifully, but we still wanted to say goodbye to John, and that was how we did it.
I'm gonna miss him.
Me too.
He's a hell of a guy.
Tough act to follow.
Throughout this series, one of the big themes for Frasier is this concept of legacy, and he seems to be really preoccupied with it. Have you ever thought about your own?
Sure, yeah. Yeah, I do. I think about it as, I hope I left him laughing, you know? And I hope I've done the world some good by having lived my life.
It's actually wild, though, if you do consider your career, right? If you reflect upon it, because you have been part of three of the most successful sitcoms of all time. Cheers, Frasier, and The Simpsons.
Hello, children.
Hello, Bart.
Yeah, right. And Hell, Simpsons, the most successful show in history. It's insane. I like being sort of a peripheral part of it, but he does cast a long shadow. As I always say, Sacha Baron casts a long shadow throughout the universe. He just is, he's the most evil animated character that ever existed. And I do take some of the credit.
I think you have to take lots of the credit. You have to have a really evil voice to be able to be the most evil character in the history of the world.
Exactly.
You also did scare a few longtime Simpsons fans because in the recent Halloween episode, Lisa kills Bob. Is this the last time that we see him?
I don't know. I recorded it almost 2 years ago. That's what always happens. So I kind of forget what happened. He does have a funny way of coming back all the time, though.
Yes.
I don't know.
Hey, baby, I hear the blues are calling. Toss salads and scrambled eggs. Mercy.
I have one more question for you, sir. After 4 decades with this character, sharing Frasier with us, have you ever figured out what you end up doing with all those tossed salads and scrambled eggs?
You know what? I've never been asked that before. So I've never answered it. Eating them.
After all this time!